So today we're going to build a manifold out of PVC that's going to allow us to divert some of the water from our pump and filter return line. As it's coming back to the pool on this end, some of the water is going to go straight out into the pool, and some of the back pressure is going to allow water to come through this part of the tee, and then we're going to be able to thread a garden hose on this end. And that garden hose will lay in the yard in the sun, collect heat, and the water that pumps through it will be heated and eventually dump back in the pool. A big part of this upgrade is that you're going to need to have 1.5 inch return, and this particular fitting right here from Hayward. So this is that Hayward return line fitting. It's basically threaded on the inside on both sides. 1.5 inch PVC standard plumbing. The way that it works, and if you've got an intex pool, you're going to need to cut a bigger hole and trace this where your current return line is, and then just kind of cut carefully with scissors kind of in a radial pattern, and then trim those pieces out. Once you've cut the bigger hole for this return line, this part right here is going to be on the inside of the pool, and you're going to feed it through the hole with one washer on there. So that's going to sandwich on one side of your liner. Then on the outside of the pool, this other washer will sandwich on the other side of the liner. And then you've got this kind of like cork / cardboard gasket. And then you'll have the nut on the other side. And you know, you just cinch this up, and it'll make a watertight seal. The other things you're going to need for this project are PVC cement, a hacksaw for cutting a couple small sections of pipe, and some emery cloth to deburr the pipe after you've cut it. So let's get started. I'm going to start by gluing this piece into the T, and we're using a 1.5 inch piece of pipe to connect those. So I'm just going to swab the inside of this piece all the way around. Put a little bit on the pipe itself. And then I'm going to put these together, push it all the way in, and kind of twist it a little bit as I do that. Cement on the pipe. And then we're going to slide that in and give it a good twist. That twist just helps kind of flatten out any air bubbles that could be in the cement. So let's put that reducer on. Just going to put some cement on the inside of our tee. Put the remainder of that around the reducer. And we're going to slide that in and give it a twist if we can. But that's all the way in. The next part, we're just going to use this small section of 3/4 inch pipe. And that's going to allow us to join this piece to the T. Just a little bit of glue on the pipe. We got to be careful not to push this too far in, because we need enough for our hose adapter to fit onto. Just gonna line this up and push it in a little bit, but not too far. And Got some cement on there. Put just a little bit around the perimeter of this pipe. Now we just need to line this up, slide it on, give it our twist. And this thing is done. So here's our finished manifold. It's going to come from the return line through here. Some of the water will go back straight into the pool. Some of it will divert here into our garden hose. We're going to use a 100-foot long hose that's going to lay in the yard. It's going to get nice and hot, and it's going to help heat that water before it goes back in the pool. So here's our pre-temperature. The water's about 82.2 degrees. I'm just going to thread this into the Hayward return fitting. Our hose.